There are a number of ways to shorten pattern pieces in Inkscape. I'll show you 5 of them, and we'll start from the top of the path menu. To do this, we'll need a pattern piece, one closed path, or at least it should be whole in the area of the cutting, and a rectangle, wider than our pattern piece and exactly our shortening amount tall. Place the rectangle over the pattern pieces where you'd like to remove the length, select both shapes, duplicate, and let's begin. I make 5 copies to demonstrate all methods. I'm working with Keywest Tank by Pattern Niche. First useful one is path, difference. It neatly cuts the rectangle shape out of the tank. The top and bottom are still attached, so we go path, break apart to separate them. Just pull them together now. We'd still need to true this line, I'll show that later. The next one, intersection, isn't useful, but we can use exclusion. It results in combined path too, so break apart again. Delete the outer rectangle remnants and pull the shapes together. If you are interested in future tutorials, consider subscribing and tell me in the comments which topics I should cover sooner. Path, division cuts the pattern piece into several, 3 in this case. Delete the center one, pull the others together. Nothing to break apart here. Right now my favorite is path, cut path. It inconveniently removes the fill, but we can put it back. I color the top and the bottom, and delete 2 pieces of the stroke at the gap. Pull together. I'm not quite sure why it overlapped 2 stroke segments, but it doesn't matter much. The thing that makes cut path better than others is it removes the stroke from the cut. With paths, if some section of it doesn't have a stroke, there are no path there. It's an empty space, and the closest nodes are end nodes. The way Inkscape works, only end nodes can be easily joined together. The 5th method is my original way. I've discovered it this summer, and it is shown as some of my videos. For this we'd need to take node tool, and add nodes to the pattern shape where it intersects the rectangle. Select the pattern piece so Inkscape would know where to add them. Double-click in these points to add nodes. Snapping setting snap to paths is handy, but not necessary for this step. Remember, Inkscape will only add nodes to the active path. Then select them all with shift or drag around them, and use break path at selected nodes, or shift B on the keyboard. I keep forgetting this shortcut. After that we'd need to break apart once again. Delete the rectangle, and the result is similar to cut path, but with fill color intact. Delete the extra stroke bits and pull the shapes together. Now to true the line. Take one of the results without the stroke. With node tool, select both pieces, pull around 2 end nodes on the cut line, and use join selected nodes button or press shift J. It can be enough for gentle curves and small adjustments. Otherwise you'd need to pull the handles to make it right. We'll use a different approach for the results with the stroke. Select both halves and switch to node tool. Zoom in a lot and pull a guide between the end nodes. Pull each node to the guide. Since our paths are cut in the same place, their strokes overlap. Which means path union will work nicely and make them one path again. Watch this video to learn what to do if union is ineffective, or when you need to choose different necklines or other pattern options, or this one if you'd rather add length to the patterns.